Step to Christ, rejoicing in the Lord. If we do represent Christ, we shall make his service appear attractive as it really is. Christians who gather up gloom and sadness to their souls and murmur and complain are giving to others a false representation of God and the Christian life. They give the impression that God is not pleased to have his children happy, and in this they bear false witness against our Heavenly Father. Satan is exalted when he can lead the children of God into unbelief and despondency. He delights to see us mistrusting God, doubting his willingness and power to save us. He loves to have us fear that the Lord will do us harm by his providences. It is the work of Satan to represent the Lord as lacking in compassion and pity. He misstates the truth in regard to him. He fills the imagination with false ideas concerning God, and instead of dwelling upon the truth in regard to our Heavenly Father, we too often fix our minds upon the misrepresentations of Satan and dishonor God by distrusting him and murmuring against him. Satan ever seeks to make the religious life one of gloom. He desires it to appear toilsome and difficult. And when the Christian presents in his own life this view of religion, he is, through his unbelief, seconding the falsehood of Satan. Many, walking along the path of life, dwell upon their mistakes and failures and disappointments, and their hearts are filled with grief and discouragement. While I was in Europe, a sister who had been doing this and who was in deep distress wrote to me asking for some word of encouragement. The night after I had read her letter, I dreamed that I was in a garden, and one who seemed to be the owner of the garden was conducting me through its path. I was gathering the flowers and enjoying their fragrance when the sister, who had been walking by my side, called my attention to some unsightly briars that were impeding her way. There she was, mourning and grieving. She was not walking in the pathway following the guide, but was walking among the briars and thorns. "Oh," she mourned, "is it not a pity that this beautiful garden is spoiled with thorns?" Then the guide said, "Let the thorns alone, for they will only wound you. Gather the roses, the lilies, and the pinks." Step to Christ, page 116.